What's up, Lash Girlies? It's your girl, Cameron Love. If you're new here, my name is Cameron Love. I am a licensed esthetician in Greensboro, North Carolina, and I'm the owner of Lash Queen Beauty Company. So today, I'm going to do a vlog of me going to speak at a school in my city. So the name of the school is Health and Style Institute, and it is actually an institute where you can get your esthetician or cosmetology license. And I was actually invited by a teacher to come and speak to the school. So that's what I'm gonna go do today. Go speak to the school and give them some insight about becoming a lash artist and talk to the girls that are interested in being lash professionals. So yeah, I just want to take you guys on this quick little journey with me. Yeah. So honestly, guys, I want to make a really good impression at the school because the school is in Greensboro, North Carolina, and because these girls are pretty much like the next group of girls who are going to be licensed and able to do lash extensions and are interested in lash extensions. I really want to impress the school, so I really want to come looking my best. So I'm going to throw on a little nice soft beat, a cute little outfit, curl my hair, and then I'm out the door. Why did I even die? You said you were.
made it in day. I've been taking on all this baggage, adding on so much weight. Had me thinking that I was average when you're really the blame. How you gonna throw it away? How you gonna sit and act like it was nothing?
Y'all, my leave out, yo, my hair looks a hot mess, but I have to finesse because my hair appointment ends until tomorrow, so we're going to have to make it do what it do. You know, the good thing about weave and leave out is you can blend it, so I'm just going to blend it real quick. I don't have time to do no extra. I'm just going to curl it because it looks much better when it's curled than when it's straight. It's easier to blend for me when it's curled because my hair kind of has a little curly wave to it. So I'm just going to blend my hair real quick, and then I'm out the door.
When you really don't play, how you gonna throw it?
So, of course, before I leave, I have to feed my son. So, Oreo has been acting really funny about his dog food lately. Oreo acts like he's too good of a dragon. So I had to switch it up a little bit. There's this new brand that I actually found on TikTok. It's called Fresh Pet. And I would see this brand in the dog store or the little pet supply store. I would see it all the time. And I'm like, I don't know if this is actually worth the hype. But y'all, I am actually really, really liking this brand. I really like that the food is real. So the formula that I had got for Oreo had carrots in it, had eggs, it had salmon and some steak. So I just feel like with having a dog, like, you want to really feed them quality food. And I was just so impressed when I looked at the ingredients of this pet food. So I think we're going to stick with it because Oreo really, really, really likes it. It's to the point now where he won't even acknowledge the dry kibble. He won't even acknowledge it. So he really, really likes Fresh Pet. So I'm going to keep it up. And with the Fresh Pet, this first time I tried to mix it. Like, I wanted to do half dry kibble and half Fresh Pet, just so Oreo doesn't get like too bougie and he's too acclimated. He doesn't want dry kibble anymore. Like, we gotta keep it, you know, we ain't too bougie around here, we eat dry kibble. But I was actually pretty pissed off because I came back home later this day and Oreo just ate the Fresh Pet only. He just completely ignored the dry kibble and it's been sitting there in that bowl. So, safe to say Oreo is really off of the dry kibble, even though I really tried to mix it to the best of my ability. Oreo is just over it. He just wants Fresh Pet only. So that's probably what we're going to end up just sticking with, is just Fresh Pet, because he really, really, really likes it. And as you can see here, he is just sitting there, like, anticipating this food, tail just a wagging, like, oh my God. Alrighty, guys, so I made it to the shop, so I'm just turning everything on. So I did make it to the shop. I don't know if y'all can see my outfit. I'm thinking about getting a breast reduction, y'all, because my boobs just kind of throw my outfit off sometimes. So, and then I have this really cute jacket. It's a cute, like, pink blazer that I have. And let me go get it so y'all can see. Here it is. So I got this from Shein, and y'all, I really was like, no, I'm not shopping at Shein, whatever, but they own us up. So I have, like, this little gray pencil skirt, this really cute blazer, do my makeup and my hair, but I'm gonna go speak at a school today, like I said. So but before I go speak, I need to get my stuff together. Yeah, so before I go speak at the school, I am going to pack my kit to see what I'm going to talk about over there. I did have some pamphlets that I wanted to get printed to hand out to them. So hopefully if I have time, I can stop and pick those up on my way there to the school. It's a nice little pamphlet, you know, just detailing what we do. Or it's not really a pamphlet, it's like a little card, like a card with our information stuff on it. So I want to go pick those up. But yeah, I'm gonna pack what I need for the demo. And yeah. Alright, y'all. So I actually, before I go, I'm just gonna, one of our customers reached out to me and said she has not received her pickup email. So I'm just gonna go into the system and see, because sometimes they go straight to spam. And she said she checked spam and it still didn't show up. So maybe I just missed it. No, I sent her email, says ready for pickup. I'm not sure why she didn't get an email. So we did send an email, but I don't know why she didn't get it. So I'm not sure. Haven't received the email. But your order is ready for pickup. And someone just sent her a quick text. I don't know why. Her order is not, like, she didn't get an email, but I did. I sent one. But anyway. Alright, so that's that. So now, like I said, I'm gonna pack what I'm gonna take to over there to talk about. Alright, y'all. So I'm actually on the way to the school. I didn't have time to go grab the cards I'm passing out, but I have to do this two times today, so I'm just gonna go pick it up on my break and then bring it for the second group, and I'll just leave extra because I don't want to be super late coming to speak to this school. So I'm on the way. I'm about 5 minutes away now. I'm a little nervous. I don't know why, because I'm just talking about being in the lash industry and having a lash business, but I've always had like a sense of stage fright in a sense. This thing is probably so annoying. I've always had like a sense of stage fright, even as a child. So I'm a little nervous, but I know that this is gonna really help Lash Queen. It's gonna help us grow, and there's nothing to be scared of. You know, it's just talking about business and how this industry has really changed my life, because it has. I almost feel like I'm financially free. I'm financially independent. My business has been doing very well. Since I've started, and every year I see growth. Our branding has improved, our marketing has improved, and you know, as the business gets older and more mature, I can't wait to get to a point where, you know, I just have a team of people that just kind of help me run Lash Queen. Ooh, a little tight in this, I ain't gonna lie, a little snug, but I'm just really excited to have like a team of people who really believe in Lash Queen. And you know, this next location I do, and I can't, you guys, like, I'm really debating between if I want to put it in Charlotte or another location, just because I feel like Charlotte is right up the street from where I am. But you know, anyway, this is just going to help me to get Lash Queen's name out there and what we're doing, and yeah, all that jazz. Going to the school because the students just so happened to stumble upon my store. I was actually, so the good thing about Lash Queen is we're conveniently located next to Cosmoprof, so a lot of the licensed professionals in the city already kind of make their way over to Cosmoprof, and because I'm right next to it, they're like, oh snap, like I have to go inside this lash store. So Lash Queen is positioned in a really good spot in the city, and this school was actually, Health and Style was actually visiting Cosmoprof as like a school field trip. Which is a good opportunity for the students to actually like see inside of a professional licensed store, because you can only shop there if you are licensed. So the students get a chance to actually, you know, be in there and, you know, feel the prestige of shopping as a licensed professional. And Lash Queen is conveniently located next door, so they kind of just stumble upon Lash Queen. But they're always like amazed when they come into the store. They're always amazed at everything. So I'm really, really excited. And y'all, I forgot my tripod. See, that's one thing. I forgot my tripod. And I forgot my batteries. And my phone is. I forgot my phone, my camera batteries. I only have one battery on me. The rest of them are at the shop. So I'm not going to be able to record a lot.
How you gonna make it so damn hard? taking on all this baggage, adding on so much weight. Had me thinking that I was average when you're really the blame. How you gonna throw it away? How you gonna sit and act like it was nothing?
So guys, the school visit went really, really well. I really think the students enjoyed it. It was such a pleasure going to Health and Style and being able to talk about being in the lash industry and just how great the lash industry is, how the lash industry, y'all look at my hair, I'm always doing something with my hair, how the lash industry has genuinely changed my life, and to get to talk about the store a little bit. So that was really, really fun. I do have to go back at 5:30 and it's 3 o'clock now. I just finished my client and I'm starving. I really want some Jamaican food, so I'm gonna order some on DoorDash, clean up that room, and make sure I'm set and ready to go for 5:30, because I want to make sure I get there by 5 and set up and ready to go and do this demo. So that's what we're doing next. I feel like today has been really productive. I feel like I am just on it today. Like, really, really and truly. And let me check the sales for the studio today. Studio sales have been bomb as well, which I'm really, really happy about. And my clientele has started to come back up, which I'm also really, really happy about. Because y'all know I have a goal to open another location this year, but also, like, okay, so we're doing really good. So studio is almost at $700 in sales for the day, so I'm really, really excited. It's not even 4 o'clock yet, so I should be able to get a couple more in by the day. Hopefully some online ones come in, but if not, that's okay. Still winning, still doing business, and honestly I'm just so thankful and so blessed that God has blessed my business this way for me to be able to go speak at schools and, you know, talk about being in the lash industry and how beneficial it has been for me and my business and my family. So I'm grateful. So yeah, y'all finna order me some curry chicken, rice and peas, and some cabbage, cause that shit finna buck. I'm trying not to curse, y'all. I'm really trying not to curse. That is gonna be a really great meal, so I'm excited. I've been laying off the fried food, and it's giving very much body, very much body, yaddy yaddy. Okay, where we're cutting back on the fried food, even though I literally just ordered some fried fish. I told y'all I was gonna get curry, but because I got white on, and I know the way I'm finna go in on this food, I figured it would be safer for me to get escovish, because I still have one more demo I need to do, and if I get curry on this outfit, I'm gonna lose it. So I took the safe route. I got some escovish coming, and I can't wait to get here because your girl is hungry. Side note, we just got these really cute rhinestone decals, and I'm going to sell them for $3 a bag. And this has plenty of little rhinestone decals for the girls to put on the lashes. So I thought this was really cute to add with the decals that we do have, and we do still have some designer ones coming in. And then we have some heart diamond decals. So these are actual, like, 3D, like, 3D gems instead of like the flat decals. These are actual 3D ones. I cannot wait for the designer ones to come in. I feel like those designer decals are gonna set it off. And so we have like Chanel ones, we have what other ones we have YSL, we have Gucci ones. So those are gonna be so freaking cute. The girls are gonna love them. Say hi to my YouTube. No, it's my daddy. How are you?
Okay, but the food, this is what I really wanted to show y'all. Check this food out. So I was gonna get curry, but like I said, because I have this outfit on and I gotta do one more speaking engagement. On the head, not on the fish. Interesting. Because I gotta do one more speaking thing, I'm not gonna have that. My mouth is watery, but looking at this food. This is escovish fish with rice and peas and some plantains. And then I got extra plantains because I'm just fat and I really like them. So I'm gonna eat yum 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 yum.
Guys, we have made it to the end of this vlog. It has been one long day. I look rough. Okay, hair look a little rough. Makeup starting to slide a little bit, but still look cute. I feel like today was really productive. I got a lot done. I was able to speak with
some future lash professionals, hopefully, and convince them to become a lash artist. So it was a really good day. Business went really well, so I'm really excited about all that. So yeah, honestly, I'm just ecstatic because I feel like I'm finally getting out here and networking. I feel like I'm finally getting in the field and talking about what I do and talking about my business, and I'm very confident talking about it now. So, and I wasn't like this some time before, so this is really exciting. And unfortunately, you guys, I didn't get any footage of me teaching today or actually talking to the professionals about becoming a lash professional, because I was too busy talking. So I feel like that's why I need a personal assistant, someone who can come with me on these sort of field trips and record what I'm doing so I can get the content for you guys. Because I feel like that was really, really fun, and it was really helpful for them. I feel like they were able to really ask questions, they were able to really watch and see what I was doing, and I got to talk to them about the revenue you can generate from being a lash professional and all that, which is really, really good. So yeah, just like I didn't get any actual footage of me doing the work, but that's okay. I do have another school visit scheduled, so I'm really excited for that. So yeah, it all kind of just works out somehow. Also, thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to tune into the next one, and I'll see you later. Bye.